Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Good evening and welcome again to another night at Boss Auditorium with 3ABN presenting Pentecost 2000. Tonight's subject is one that is going to have an impact on everyone in this room as well as around the world very soon. As a matter of fact, you will find before the night is over that the steps have already been laid and it's just a matter of God simply releasing his permission for the mark of the beast to be implemented. I like to say for those who are in churches around as well as here for the first time that God must really have a special plan for your life because you're going to hear some very startling truth. And the only reason why God would allow you to hear this truth is because he is trusting that you will first of all obey his word and then secondly teach others who don't know. There are thousands and thousands of Christians that don't have any idea at all what the mark of the beast is. Some of them are actually in the process of receiving it and they don't know it all. And they are sincere Christians. If we are faithful to the trust that God gives us, people will follow God and not man. And so I pray that you would ask God to open your heart and mind. And for those who are here, after we finish the presentation, I will wait in case there are any questions because it's too serious just for me to put it out there. As a matter of fact, if a minister said what I'm going to say to you tonight, I would want to ask questions. I'd want to make sure if I had any doubts in my mind so that I would have a clear understanding of the will of God. Would you please kneel with me as we have a word of prayer before we enter into tonight's subject? Father in heaven, I surrender my heart to you, Lord, even now. And I pray for the outpouring of your spirit to please touch my tongue and each heart. Allow this message to go around the world because this message will bring on your coming. And Lord, I want you to come. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If someone came in this room tonight and there were no video cameras on and they robbed everyone in the room, is you going up and down? My mic is going in and out. And they robbed everyone in this room, thank you. And the video cameras didn't pick it up. Well, the police would come in and the first thing they would do is they'd ask each one of us for a description of who the person was or who the individuals were, and we would each give what we felt a description of the person was as accurately as we possibly could, and they'd have a sketch artist that would draw and erase, and to finally they had a perfect composite, and to everybody said, yes, that's the man. And then they would copy them, and they'd send them all out around Thompsonville, around Benton, around the various areas, and they would simply say, if you see this man, we want to apprehend him. Now, if we all said that the man was 6'2", he had orange hair, he had a scar coming down the side of his ear, and he also was missing an arm. And they went and they found a man that had orange hair, that was missing an arm, that had a scar coming down his ear, but he was only 4'11". Even though that man may have looked just like him, it couldn't be the man. Amen? In the Bible, it gives a description of the beast's power, and then the Bible comes to a conclusion of what his mark is. Whatever entity or whatever person, whether it's a monster coming out of the ocean, and I'll tell you tonight, it's not a monster coming out of the ocean, or whether it's the computer that I believe is in Chicago that they call the beast, if it does not fit perfectly every characteristic in Revelation chapter 13, then it cannot be that beast's power. And so what we want to do tonight is open our Bibles to Revelation 13. And what we want to do is pull out all the characteristics of this beast's power, then identify who the beast is, then show where we are today, show what role America will play, and then, I guess, the only thing will be left is for everyone to make a decision. And by the way, everyone will make a decision. We're in it whether we want to be or not. Unfortunately, the whole world is involved. It has implications that are a lot stronger than any man can ever handle, because Satan is behind it. And God is allowing him to play his cards out. So first of all, what I'd like to do is just read responsibly the book of Revelation 13. I'll read one, you read one. And I stood upon the sand of the sea and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having seven heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his heads the name of blasphemy. And I saw one of his heads as it were wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed, and all the world wandered after the beast.
And they worshipped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worshipped the beast, saying, Who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him?
And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies. And power was given unto him to continue 42 months. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations.
And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world.
If any man have an ear, let him hear. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had 2 horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein should worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed.
And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. He had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Altogether, here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Amen. So let's go back to verse 1, and let's dissect this. John the Revelator is in jail. He's on the Isle of Patmos. And he begins this chapter by saying, I stood upon the sand of the sea, and saw a what? And saw a what? And saw a beast. So you want to put on your paper, beast equals a kingdom. Beast equals kingdom. And you want to write Daniel chapter 7, verse 23. Beast equals kingdom, just like it is on the screen. If I move too fast, please just feel free to say slow down. Amen? Beast equals what, brothers and sisters? Kingdom. And we want to turn to Daniel chapter 7, and we want to make sure